Meanwhile, the left demonstrates that they do, in fact, have complete Trump derangement syndrome. So Jeanine Pirro of Fox News was on The View. How is Jeanine Pirro gets me on The View and I don't get to be on The View? What is the deal here, guys? Okay, what is this? I've been begging you to book me on The View for literally years at this point. Now, I understand you don't want to have me on The View. I get you don't want to have me on The View because it's going to get weird and ugly. But that's the whole point. Don't you want it to be good TV? So anyway, they have Jeanine Pirro on, and it does get weird and ugly. So Jeanine Pirro says to Whoopi Goldberg that she has Trump derangement syndrome, which is clearly true. And things get wild.
Wait, here's my question for you, because Trump you talk about
I am not, Judge.
Nobody did you just point at me?
Yes.
Listen, I don't have Trump derangement. Let me tell you what I have.
Okay, and then it gets crazier from there. Whoopi eventually goes so nuts that she essentially throws Jeanine Pirro off the set because Jeanine Pirro says that Whoopi Goldberg has Trump derangement syndrome, which she clearly does. Here's Whoopi Goldberg losing her mind, saying, I'm done, and then bringing this nutty segment to a crashing halt.
You know what's horrible?
What's
horrible? When the President of the United States whips up people to beat the hell out of people.
No.
Say goodbye.
Let me bye.
I'm done. Thank you to Judge Jeanine Pirro for both liars, leaders, and liberals.
Okay, and so it ends like that. But then it gets even worse. So Jeanine Pirro was on Sean Hannity's radio show the other day, and Jeanine Pirro explains what happened directly after that little tiff.
When I went off the stage, Sean, I was walking down. And I said something like, Whoopi, I fought for victims my whole life. And she came at me as I was leaving. And she said, F you, in my face, literally spitting at me. F you, get the F out of this building.
Okay, so obviously she does not have Trump derangement syndrome, Whoopi Goldberg. Obviously she's a completely sane person, having normal political discourse. This is the level to which things have sunk. Okay, the level to which I think Whoopi Goldberg is representative of a hardcore base of leftists, that this is how they feel, that anyone who disagrees with them is an evil, evil human being, and you can't even have a discussion about the issues. Now, look, Jeanine Pirro is a very pro-Trump guest. There's no question, but they knew that when they booked her. If you're going to have Jeanine Pirro on, you at least have to let her talk. This idea that you bring on a guest and you don't let them talk is so beyond absurd to me. I don't understand it at all. When we do our Sunday specials here on The Ben Shapiro Show, one of the things that I do is I bring in people who disagree. I brought in Sam Harris. I brought in Eric Weinstein. I bring in people from the left all the time. We invite tons of leftist guests who won't even come because they don't want to do an interview. And I let them talk for like 15 minutes at a stretch because you want to know what they think so then you can critique what they think. But the left has decided that even having these conversations is to grant credibility to a side so evil that they must not be heard. And Whoopi Goldberg has a slot on that show every single day. Everybody in the audience knows what Whoopi Goldberg thinks about these things. Wouldn't it behoove Whoopi Goldberg and the folks on The View to at least let Jeanine Pirro make her point of view known? Especially because you know the audience is going to laugh at Jeanine Pirro anyway, because it's a View audience. It demonstrates real cowardice. Props to Bill Maher. Props to Bill Maher. Bill Maher had me on a couple of weeks ago, and props to Bill Maher, who actually let me talk. We had a reasonable conversation. We disagreed about nearly everything. His audience was against me. He acknowledged that at the very beginning, and then we had a reasonable conversation. Good for people like Bill Maher, really, because there are very few of these folks left in American discourse, and Whoopi Goldberg and Joy Behar on The View demonstrate it pretty much every day. It's really, really quite pathetic.